Mic test, 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 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, good, you're good, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, I'm finished my numbers in English.
I didn't want to say that. That's the first thing I heard. He's in the building. Elvis is in the building. That's all I care
Sorry to hold you all up. We're waiting for the representative from the Secret Service and the FBI. Is there anybody live streaming right now?
Yes.
All of us.
All right. Because we're going to have a little talk about rules of the road before we get started. You already know those, don't you, Al?
I do, sure. I can almost
we've been around too long.
We have, yeah. Maybe I'll hear something new that I...
No, I don't think so. I don't think so.
Yes.
10987654321. We're good?
You guys want to wait balance or anything, Dave?
Okay. That's pretty sad when I know how to do that.
It shows experience.
Thank you.
trying not to. It's like a stack of dominoes here. Don't breathe.
Okay, guys, you ready?
Yes,
little rules of the road like we always talk about ahead of time. We are going to give you, when I say we have a representative from the FBI, from the Secret Service, from the State Attorney's Office. We are going to give you everything we have. Everything. All right? So when we get done, think about your questions because we're not going to take a lot. And keep them to the information that you heard. Don't get into what ifs and because of this. We're not going to go there. All right? So keep that in mind. And we'll be good. So here we go. All right, 1:30 this afternoon. Call came out, shots fired. That was called in by the Secret Service. Because we're in constant contact with them all the time, we were notified of that, and we had units here that immediately sealed off the area. Fortunately, we were able to locate a witness that came to us and said, hey, I saw the guy running out of the bushes. He jumped into a black Nissan, and I took a picture of the vehicle and the tag, which was great. So we had that information. Our real-time crime center put it out to the license plate readers, and we were able to get a hit on that vehicle on I-95 as it was headed into Martin County. We got a hold of Martin County Sheriff's Office, alerted them, and they spotted the vehicle and pulled it over and detained the guy. After that, we took the witness that witnessed the incident, flew him up there, and he identified as the person that he saw running out of the bushes and jumped into the car. Now, in the bushes where this guy was is an AK-47 style rifle with a scope, two backpacks which were hung on the fence that had ceramic tile in them, and a GoPro, which he was going to take pictures of. So those are being processed right now. The Secret Service agent that was on the course did a fantastic job. What they do is they have an agent that jumps one hole ahead of time to where the president was at. And he was able to spot this rifle barrel sticking out of the fence and immediately engage that individual, at which time the individual took off. So that's what we know about the investigation. We have somebody in custody right now that is a potential suspect. We got a little bit more work to do on it, but as we usually do, as soon as we decide that we're going to book him into the county jail and the charges that he's going to be booked into, we'll get those to you and we'll get a picture of him and we'll get you his background. So now I'm going to turn it over to the representative of the Secret Service and he's going to make a brief statement.
Hi, good afternoon, everyone. I first want to thank all of our law enforcement partners, to include the Palm Beach Sheriff's Office and the Martin County Sheriff's Office, for their involvement today. Former President Donald Trump is safe and unharmed following a protective incident shortly before 2 p.m. on Sunday at Trump International Golf Club at West Palm Beach. The U.S. Secret Service personnel opened fire on a gunman located near the property line, and this matter is under investigation. I'll turn it over to my partners over at the FBI.
Good afternoon, everyone. My name is Jeffrey Veltri. I'm the special agent in charge of the FBI's Miami field office. The FBI has assumed the role as the lead federal law enforcement agency in the investigation of the incident that occurred earlier today at Trump International Golf Course here in West Palm Beach, Florida. We've deployed a number of resources, including investigative teams, crisis response team members, bomb technicians, and evidence response team members as well. What we need right now is for the public to avoid the area around the golf course. We will continue to support this investigation with the full resources of the FBI, alongside our partners with the United States Secret Service and the Palm Beach Sheriff's Office, as well as Martin County Sheriff's Office and state and local law enforcement. I would ask that if anyone has any information that may assist with this investigation, to contact our tip line at 1-800-CALL-FBI or at tips, that's T-I-P-S dot FBI dot gov. Thank you.
David?
Hi, I'm Dave Ehrenberg, State Attorney for Palm Beach County. I want to thank Sheriff Bradshaw and our partners at the local, state, and federal levels. I'm here because our prosecutors are currently working up warrants and a motion for pretrial detention for the suspect. In that way, he will be kept in custody. But our filing of these warrants and charges at the state level does not preclude federal charges that could be coming. But in the meantime, it looks like the warrants and the pretrial detention motion will happen first. And again, I want to thank the cooperation we've had with our federal partners and at the local level. And thank you all for being here today.
Okay, we're going to make these pictures available to you. It'll show you a picture of the backpack and the rifle. And there's also a GoPro on the fence there where he was intent on filming what was going on. Even though we're going to have to secure a couple areas around the golf course here, the public doesn't need to panic. We know that we got a post office, a library, and a school down the street. So we'll make it convenient for you to get to all the places you need to go, get your kids to school, get them over here to the post office or wherever else you need to go. It's safe, there's no more danger here, and we'll make it very convenient for you. So having said that, we're gonna take a very limited amount of questions, and you can direct them to who you want to answer the question.
Sheriff, did this individual make any statements as he was being detained?
No statement right now as far as his involvement in the incident, and there's further investigation to be completed.
What was his demeanor?
That is correct, yes.
And the president or former president was on the course behind him. How close?
It was one or two holes behind.
100%.
That, because the bubble moves through the golf course, so our agents will get there first, clear it. He noticed that the rifle was pointing out, our agents engaged. We are not sure right now if the individual was able to take a shot at our agents. But for sure, our agents were able to engage with the
suspect.
I don't know that.
Doesn't appear so.
Is there a moment?
Yep. Yeah.
How far away was the president? How far away was Donald Trump when this gentleman was caught and stopped?
Probably between 300 and 500 yards, but with a rifle and a scope like that, that's not a long distance.
For the Secret Service, how far was your agent from the would-be assailant?
That I'm not sure right now. That's, we're still looking into
reports
that.
Reports of the 4 rounds of ammunition were fired. Were all 4 of those from your agent?
That is correct. 4 to 6. We're not sure yet.
Was there a long distance? Explaining why.
Yes. Yes.
Thank you.
And
yes, ma'am. Say that one more time and talk up a little bit.
So how was this able to happen, and for future reference, is there any up security on the golf course?
Well, you got to understand the golf course is surrounded by shrubbery. So when somebody gets into the shrubbery, they're pretty much out of sight. All right. And at this level that he is at right now, he's not the sitting president. If he was, we would have had this entire golf course around it. But because he's not, the security is limited to the areas that the Secret Service deems possible. So I would imagine that the next time he comes to the golf course, there'll probably be a little bit more people around the perimeter. But the Secret Service did exactly what they should have done. They provided exactly what the protection should have been, and their agent did a fantastic job.
Which direction was the shrubbery? Was it north, south? West to south to the road?
The layout of the golf course, you've got three holes, 5, 6, and 7. All right? One of them runs parallel to Summit Boulevard. One of them runs parallel to Congress. And he was in an area in the shrubbery where he could see both holes. So the president was another hole back, which means he's about between 400 and 500 yards away.
So he was on the golf course?
Oh, he's on the golf course, yeah, but he's back a ways.
For the Secret Service, have you guys changed at all the way that you guys are protecting former President Donald Trump? This is now a potential second attempt on him. Can you just elaborate on how things have changed and what you made of all this?
Yes, the threat level is high. We have increased the amount of assets that we've supported. So we are, we live in danger times, so yes.
Okay. We're done with questions right now. There's really nothing more for us to add. I just want to tell you, the Secret Service and the FBI and the State Attorney's Office have been fantastic to work with. And I can tell you right now, our agency with this real-time crime center was fabulous. That's how we got the guy. We started out with, we don't know anything, to where we had a tag, we had a vehicle description, and we got an area where we saw the person. So be proud of your law enforcement. All right. Thanks, folks. We'll get back to you.
Where on 95 was it that...
Yeah, she'll get the photos to you.
Yeah. Okay, cool. Go ahead. I appreciate it.
After hi there.
Down
how you
here,
doing?
This footage as well. Off board.
Sure. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10.
Of course. Thank you so much for your. No worries. That's what's the fun. That's all fun. Bye bye. My pleasure.
Thank you.
Sure.
objects, and officials say they are aware of it. The former president does live here in Florida, and so this year we do see stepped up security or suppression of these.
Yes, I can hear you.
Along those seats, which is about 15 minutes from the golf course. At this point, everyone is just sort of on alert, certainly long supply on alert, given what has happened, just sort of making sure that the former president is safe. But it's just so troubling. Here we understand that this suspect was just about 500 yards away from the former president. And, we know that they recovered some weapons, a weapon from the first place. Along with that, and apparently a GoPro camera. So the identity of the suspect has not yet been released, but they do believe that the passenger who was in the vehicle is the same individual. The same one of the horses here at the golf course. Of course, they have to wait for his proper ID, and they have to wait to see what charges he has.
Yep, the fanatic. I'm sorry, I was writing both things. I apologize. Some cop. I got you. Okay, so because Maria told me otherwise, but I'm clear to go ahead and do your thing. You know what I'm saying? I don't want to. Oh.
Yeah, I'm clear.
I got you then. I got you, my friend. I got you then. You'll call me back? All right, thank you, my friend. Bye-bye.
Okay, cool. Exit is at 6:30. Okay, thank you so much. I'll call back. I'll come back in 10 minutes.
We can. I just don't think they will. Hi, Andre.
Just doing beer with us.
Okay.
Help me out. I appreciate it.
Oh, yeah, I'm sorry. I'm
no, man.
Feeding a live bump shot.
So I guess we're doing the same thing.
Yeah.
Thanks, man.
Good one. they caught him on I-95.
Yeah, it's chilling when you think about it. It's at 300
where you're going to go, so I don't want to keep this on.
Yeah, how about another one? Oh, we're not starting. If we pop it up.
Yeah.
You need power for your phone?
Oh no, for a light. But
Oh, you don't have one. You're more than welcome, my brother.
Thank you.
All right.
So, whatever time you guys release me, then I'm gonna probably go home and take a nap and come back. And I'll leave all my shit. We're gonna put another tent right here.
What is going on with that? I guess just people have a lot of time, huh? Oh, yeah, right. Well,
we're good, my brother. Thank you.
Okay, gotcha. Yeah, please let them know. I heard them on IFB, but I never heard the bridge.
Are you good with that? Do you want to change it?
tells you, well, look, the Secret Service has said that they have already stepped up some of the security around the former president, given what happened in Butler, Pennsylvania, about 2 months ago. We're right across the street from Trump International Golf Club, where this incident took place. We know that this area has been practically on a lockdown by law enforcement since this incident took place. And as Anna just mentioned, you know, we don't have CBS News has been able to confirm the identity of this suspect, Ryan Wesley Routh. We are told that he is in his late 50s. He had prior encounters with law enforcement, according to CBS News sources, and we understand that the suspect did not resist when he was taken into custody. Again, all of this going down around 1:30 p.m. earlier today. This area is not used to this type of security. This is about 15 minutes away from the Mar-a-Lago State, which is Trump's permanent residence. This is the golf course, but he doesn't golf quite often. It was supposed to be a sort of a quiet Sunday for the president after he had spent the week following the debate and some campaigning as well. At this point, the investigation is ongoing. We know that this individual is in custody. He has a history with law enforcement. Again, he's in his business. At this point, the investigation continues. Here, what sort of charges are going to be brought against Chelsea?